You became a musician later in life, around age 40.
Yes.
Why were you attracted to jazz in particular?
Well, if you follow the origins, if you follow jazz, the story of jazz, and you go to the origin story, Southeastern Native peoples were there. We were part of that origin story. So I like to say that one day the saxophone will be known as a traditional Muscogee Creek instrument, because that's how things happen. Cultures, a healthy culture is a living being, like a living, healthy organism. And in that, there's movement. When there is no movement, when people, you know, put up walls to stop movement, is when a culture dies.
How is jazz affiliated or close to poetry?
What I love about jazz, and I love music, period. I love our all the elements of jazz and blues can be found in our traditional Muscogee Creek music. But what I love about jazz is the ability to move.
To move?
Yes, the ability to move through certain structures and beyond them and outside and then come back in.
It does feel like poetry.
Yes, it does, because of course there's all kinds of poetry, and there's many ways that people move, and some are much more formal, and yet it becomes powerful. Formalism becomes powerful when you find a way to move within that. Mm-hmm. Jazz is similar to that, but there are many kinds of jazz. And
you've been working on a show called We Were There When Jazz Was Invented. Have we lost the indigenous contributions to jazz?
That's what sparked that whole story, is that we've lost the indigenous contributions to not just jazz and blues and music, but to almost any profession, any art. You know, we've been
a contribution to any art form.
Yes.